Welcome to the session, viewers. This is Michelle, and you're watching Skillopedia, the place to learn skills for the real world. And this is 100% true. You are learning real skills for the real world. You've already seen a lot of our videos about job interview skills. But if you think carefully, which is the most important part of your job application? Can you think of it? Well, the most important part is your application. And while you're applying, the first step is sending your CV across. And if that is not good enough, my dear, you're not going to make a good impression on your prospective employer. So in this session today, you are going to learn 7 powerful ways to make an effective CV to cast a perfect first impression on your employer. So keep watching this session. You really cannot miss it. This is Skillopedia. The most frequent question that I've heard with regard to an effective CV is, should I upload it on a job portal? Yes or no? The answer is relative, which means that it's both yes and no. It's yes for a different situation and no for a different situation. So when is the answer no? If you're working for another organization right now at the moment and you're interested in applying elsewhere, then that is the time when you need to upload secretly. Your uploading should be discreet, which means that your CV should not be public. If it is public, then there's a high possibility that your colleagues will find out your interest and they might report to the higher-ups. If that doesn't happen, then the HR, when they're updating their job openings, will surely see your interests, and that might clash with your work, and you may tend to lose the current job as well while looking for another one. And that's surely not a good experience. All right, so this answer can also be yes. But it is yes when you have already made it clear at work that you're soon going to quit. This happens when you give a notice period or you have verbally conveyed it to your employers that you're soon going to quit for various reasons. So if you're looking for new career opportunities and you want to publicize that, then that's the time when you need to make your CV public over job portals. The more public it is, the better it is, and it'll be easier for employers to find you, track you, and employ you. Very important tip while designing your CV is to choose an appropriate job title. What this means is, how do you promote yourself? That one word or a set of 2 to 3 words that allow you to promote yourself. Using these words, headhunters will search for you and recruit you. They will see whether or not you're the apt candidate and what do you really have to offer to the organization and where is your place in that organization. So you have to be very careful while choosing a job title. One of my students chose the job title marketing professional, and I think that was a great title. But at the same time, I was questioning her that how many people do you think will type these two words to find your position. And I asked her to research more. So when she researched more on this, she found some more alternatives to marketing professional, like marketing analyst, marketing specialist, marketing executive, marketing manager, marketing coordinator. You have to find out from your people or your professionals that which is the most frequently used job title for your position. And once you have decided that, you're way to go. Because through this, the headhunters are going to find you. And it's even better if the title is more specific. So what kind of a marketing specialist are you? Are you a strategist specialist, Or are you a social media specialist? If you can specify that, it's even better for the recruiters to find you. decide the keywords for your CV. Keywords are the words which are the most important in your CV. So words like a marketing specialist is definitely very important. So it's necessary that the first word, which is marketing, should appear over and over again in your CV. Maybe for your past jobs or your present jobs, obviously wherever it's relevant. But what is the purpose? Well, if you have this word over and over again in your CV, you will appear higher in the search rank and it'll be easier to find you. So use this tip, decide on your keywords and use them over and over again in your CV. Your CV should be two things at a time. It should be brief and it should be detailed. Yes, it's possible to do that. You can give a clear description of your previous jobs. That's when your CV is detailed, so that your employer or anyone who views your profile can know that you have a rich track record, which means that you've had great experience in the past and you're suitable for the position that you've applied for. Apart from this, there's another point that you need to consider, and that is there are certain jobs that you need to leave out on the CV. So if you're a very experienced candidate, let's say that you're 30 and you're a director of a startup, and you have mentioned on your CV about a high school job that you did in a summer camp, that's not really useful. So avoid that, leave it out because it's unnecessary. So give detailed description of useful and appropriate jobs. There's one more thing that I want you to remember about your CV, and that is when you're describing your past jobs, it could be that you could be playing more than one role at a company that you were working with. For example, in my case, in my previous company, I was an English teacher, and at the same time, I was editing their global materials, and I also edited their cultural magazine. So I was more than one thing at a time. While being an English teacher, I held two other positions. So this is what you call a rich track record, and it should be clearly displayed on your CV. This one is definitely a $1 million tip. When you've done all your hard work and you've made such a perfect, effective CV, everything can go wrong in just one step, and that is, if you've not checked the PDF version of your Word CV, it could appear highly disorganized if the employer downloads it as a PDF file. So it's necessary that if you've made a Word document, you see it as a PDF file too, because sometimes certain symbols on the Word can appear as blanks on PDF, and that is when it becomes an absolute disaster. So make sure that you download the PDF version of your CV and see whether it appears as organized and clear or not. And I also recommend that you should actually make a PDF version and send it or upload it on job portals. That is because a PDF version is more secure and it does not allow editing. So follow this tip surely. Your CV and it's all ready to go, there's one very important step that you need to take care of. You need to start looking around for recommendations. Recommendations are letters from your previous employers or current employers about your professionalism. They show that how good a professional are you. You could ask this from a colleague or a higher up, and this is a very good dose of social proof for your prospective employer. So make sure that you ask for recommendations because this will really help you. Once your CV is shortlisted, the next thing that the employer is going to ask you is for recommendations. So you should have it ready in case it's required. The final tip that I have for you is that before you send your CV across, make sure that you check your spellings. Yes. This is a fatal error or a fatal mistake that a lot of professionals make. I have come across a lot of professional CVs where they have made some really silly errors with regard to spellings, especially for business words. So make sure that you check your spellings or you ask someone to proofread your document for you, someone who's really proficient in English, so that if there are any grammatical mistakes or spelling errors, they can correct it for you and you do not appear to be very sloppy to the employer. So this is my final tip for you, but I'm not going to close it here. I have a bonus tip because you stayed till the end. And that tip is with regard to your LinkedIn profile. Please remember that your LinkedIn profile is one platform where your employers can see you and see your credibility as well. So you must try your LinkedIn profile to be a reflection of your CV. That's going to definitely increase your credibility. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching this session with me, Michelle. I had a really great time sharing these 7 powerful tips about improving your CV. Please use them, and I wish you all the very best for your future applications. Let me know if they've been helpful to you in the comments below. Thank you so much. This is Michelle signing off. Bye-bye.